And hi, welcome to another lecture in NKU, Northern Kentucky University's Drawing Lecture Series. I'm Professor Mark Leone, and today we're going to be discussing drawing. I'll be demoing, you'll be drawing with me, the cylinder, and also specifically the ellipse, meaning that the top of a form of the cylinder, when you view it flat, in either way, becomes a true circle. However, when we begin to look at that in perspective, let me come a little closer and we get it to your eye level. Notice how it disappears as it gets closer to you and becomes a very flat disc or ellipse. Whether it's at eye level or it becomes or disappears at some point and then reemerges in the sky plane, you can start to see it, I'm sure. Then as we go down, it reemerges in the ground plane. Now, the closer it gets to eye level, that true circle, the closer it gets, becomes flatter and flatter to a disc, then disappears into almost a straight line. The further away it gets, and I'll back up so we can see this better, the further away it gets from your eye level looking downwards, it becomes flatter, still an ellipse, but it becomes more of a true circle until you, when you look straight upon it, looking straight down at something, then it becomes a true circle. So most students draw cylinders and ellipses pretty well in terms of getting the length and the bottom, but it's when they have a lot of problems at the top, when it's close to eye level, they'll start to draw it as if they're looking straight over it. So how do we correct that? Let me show you a little bit of theory behind that. We'll set up a one-point perspective system, and then we'll just start to sketch freehand really quickly, and we'll do a fast, quick lecture on drawing cylinders and also ellipses. Okay, so let's get started. So I'll come over here, I'll grab a pencil, and I'll set up a little system over here, one-point system. Here's my horizon line, so you know about that now already. Here's my vanishing point over here, I'll label that VP. And let's create a one-point box form in the ground plane that looks like it would not set up nicely for a nice, thin cylinder. So we have that, and we have that. And I'll tighten it up so we can see that. So there's your rectangle for your cylinder. And then we want to project convergence lines for our vanishing point. So let's do that with the top and the bottom. Okay. Now we're going to be drawing a six-sided one-point cube, and I'll show you why so we can feel all the sides of the cylinder. So I'm going to project the depth of this box about right there. I'll put a dot where I want the length of it, then I just trace over the convergence line right there. Then I bring up that straight line up to my next convergence line here. So that convergence line, that I trace over it, and then I bring that length over in my one point right there. Okay? And of course we've got that right in through there. Alright. Let's draw the back of this. How do we do that? Well, I'll show you. So what we want to do now is we want to project from this bottom left corner all the way back to the vanishing point. Okay, gets us that. Now I'll draw this in green and I'll show you what's going to happen. I'll sketch it. So you see quickly we'll have this across to the right, excuse me, to the left back corner, and then that will match up nicely to there. So let's tighten this up here. And let's tighten that up there, and now we have a nice six-sided one-point box in perspective. All right, so what about the cylinder now? Well, let me show you. We're gonna draw a crossing X up here, here, and here for a cylinder. There's our true center. So we find that. We can find it down below by doing the same thing here. And there, here's our true center. They bring up a nice vertical line, and notice how they meet right there. Okay, we've got that. And now we need a few more little reference points so we can draw our ellipse. So from the center here, we go back to the vanishing point, converges line through and through. We're looking for that point. Do the same thing at the bottom. Here and here. And now we want to bring a straight line across. It almost kind of looks like an asterisk mark here and here. Same thing on the bottom. Here and here. There and there. Okay, so now we have nice projections for what's going to be our cylinder. I'll go back and draw that in red. So now we're going to have an ellipse looking down from eye level or horizon line. What does that look like? Well, now we have some reference points to draw the ellipse. Most of the time, 99.99%, I just sketch it freehand because I know the perspective on it. But I want to show you a little bit of the mechanical understanding. You need to know that. Here, there's part of the ellipse, nice and rounded. As you're moving through, the only points they touch is where the dot around that box. Come all the way over. You can see that way on over. And there's your ellipse in perspective. Let's do the bottom. Or we could bring this down already to help us out. Let's do that. We can do that. Well, let's do the bottom, actually. I think it's a better way to see it. So now we're looking further down in perspective here on this ellipse. So we'll come through here. Here and all the way over. We have a nice one-point ellipse. And now we can draw a vertical line where they meet on the edge here and there. And there we have your very nice one-point ellipse in perspective. But let me darken that in for you so you'll see that. Because we have a lot of information there that we're looking at that we want to tighten up. So we have that. And now I'm going to only outline the parts that we see here and here. And then around this edge. So that's a true one point in linear perspective with a pretty close vanishing point. This plane comes across like that, cutting through. So there we go. If I did a little bit of shading on it, we have that. This would kind of contour around like so. Maybe I'll hatch a little bit here, cross hatch too, as well, so you'll see it. And we have maybe a little shadow on the other side. And if I throw a little light to draw over that to kind of take some of the lines away. There's my chalk, there it goes. Light through there. Maybe some light on top. Around the edge. And now we have a nice one-point cylinder. Now, it gets a little distorted down here because of the perspective, and that's fine in this case, but let's start sketching freehand a little bit further. Now, you could do this for a ground plane cylinder, you could do it for a cylinder in eye level, and you could do it for a cylinder in the sky plane, but I want to show you just what's going on perceptually when you look at objects as opposed to going through all of this particular structural component perspective. Very fundamentally sound to know it, but we won't have as much time for this particular lecture to get into that. So let me start to sketch a little bit for you, just freehand here so you see some of that. Okay, so let's just draw some cylinders in different positionings. We'll draw some in sky ground plane, roughly eye level sky plane, but also tilted, foreshortened, coming at you a little bit, so you'll see what's happening. So I'll draw another one like this one over here. Let me get my material out of the way. So we've got another ellipse, and then I'll bring down the verticals of my ellipse. And a lot of times what I do when I draw cylinders, I'll just put a guideline for me. I know it can't be straight across. And actually, when we look down on a form, if you're drawing a bowl, etc., and so on, this bottom ellipse will be more curved than that one. Why? Because it's further away from us, and so it flattens out closer to, although it's not a circle. So we have another ellipse in through there. Okay, so that's another ground plane ellipse. What if we have a cylinder that's roughly in eye level? Well, what might happen then, well, I'll kind of just draw out a rectangle. But it's the same situation when you draw a one-point box at eye level. You don't see the top or bottom. Here's what might happen. You'll see a slight curve at the top. Your vertical's coming down. They don't end at a point. They kind of curve over. They come down. And this curves over too, in through here. And now you have a one-point cylinder. If I put a little shadow tone here, a little shadow tone over here. And so now we have that as a cast shadow from that cylinder. And so what you see is, you see the cylinder moving across the top, downwards, over, but the contour line gets flatter and flatter to eye level, and then it starts to curve down and down and down and over, and then we have the nice bottom sitting down on, in this case, the ground plane, right in through there. So we have another cylinder. Very different in look, obviously, from this one, because here we see on top of it, through it, and here we can't quite see on top of it, and we can't, obviously, we can't see the bottom because it's on